Several people are dead, many others are injured right now after a pedestrian bridge collapsed at Florida International University. Right now, local authorities are holding a press briefing on the incident. Let's listen in. Here in Miami, you've been listening in on a live press conference after that. A bridge collapsed. There are several people dead right now. Others are injured. And of course, they're talking about making calls to the kin of those who have been killed in that accident. So we'll keep an eye on that on air and, of course, online at WXYZ.com. All right, state lawmakers put Michigan State's interim president, John Engler, in the hot seat today. Dan Mullen is here right now with how Engler answered questions about what the university is doing in the wake of the Larry Nassar sex abuse scandal. So he was in the hot seat.
A lot of questions.
Sure, they were firing a lot of questions.
Absolutely. A lot of investigations, questions of the interim president today, looking for answers on how the school handled the complaints, Carolyn, regarding Larry Nassar's behavior, and how to make sure history does not repeat itself on the MSU campus. They were assured the committee there's more accountability for reporting sex abuse cases now. He says a loophole for reports of sex abuse has been closed. He says investigators are working on 84 cases of sexual misconduct, and right now there are formal investigations in 28 cases.
It's interesting when you look at the Michigan State data and look at it compared to the Big Ten public institutions in this state. We're kind of in the middle of the, I guess, the middle of the rankings, if you will. But this is one where we want to win the Big Ten championship and see if we can't compete for the national championship in terms of having the fewest assaults, the fewest incidents reported, and the most secure campus.
Engler telling lawmakers the school has taken steps to increase transparency. That's been one of the serious criticisms of MSU through this. He also said MSU is making sure everyone knows how to report sex abuse, and he added the school is cooperating with investigators and trying to settle litigation. Engler said taxpayers and students are likely to get hit with that cost. Was asked about a report saying Michigan State blames new legislation for stalling negotiations with survivors. Engler said the legislation didn't stall the talks. Instead, he says it interfered with them. So some people, still many, not happy with the way the university has handled this from the get-go. Some unhappy at this point, including, I think, some lawmakers. But much more to be learned still. Questions to be answered, and there will be more questions as well of those now in charge of leadership positions at Michigan State University.
Sure, they have a long way to go. I'm sure we'll follow it to the end. Meantime, calls for change are growing louder at Eastern Michigan University. The cuts have led to layoffs, unfilled positions, and cutbacks in course offerings to students. Demonstrators say the university is spending way too much money on athletics.